By Congress MP Dr. Shashi Tharoor. So first the question I want to ask is, the Congress party as now don't have any active leadership. Sonia Gandhi ji is is not in a good health. So do you think what will be the future of the Congress party?
No, first of all, they are more active than you think. Obviously this COVID era has been the problem for everyone, because it has limited our movements, limited our ability to have, mass events, demonstrations, meetings and so on. And that has definitely cramped our style as a political party. But given that, we've been as active as it's possible to be in the circumstances. Certainly in the public policy space, we have been very clear, we've been outspoken, we've been loud. And I do want to stress that as far as the party leadership is concerned, we are determined, from what we've heard from our leaders, to ensure that we become the fulcrum of an effective opposition. This government has done so much damage to the country. We really need an effective opposition to resist it.
There is a old G23, old guard dissenters, and the one of your lost strongholds in Punjab. There is a growing factionalism. So do you think the Congress party is losing its edge?
Not at all. Factionalism, unfortunately, is a reality in most democratic parties, and we've seen this in the Congress for decades. It's not a new phenomenon. In my own state of Kerala, there are factions and groups with the official labels even. Similarly, pretty much in every part of the country, democracy is something which encourages the expression of individual views, interests, preferences and opinions. I am not too worried about that, because in what I've seen in Kerala, for example, is whatever the differences may be, when it's matters like elections and so on, all the factions come together. And I'm sure we'll see the same thing in Tamil Nadu and elsewhere. The important thing for a party is to ensure that everyone is on board. And that is something we will spend some time doing.
There is a growing criticism that the Congress party is, working as an opposition only in the Twitter and in social media. So it is, not doing any field works. So is that true?
I don't think that's true. It's certainly been, shall we say, given a certain amount of credibility by the reality of COVID. But apart from that constraint, even during COVID, the Congress has been very active. No group, including the government, has been more active on COVID relief than the Indian Youth Congress, giving oxygen cylinders, masks, supplies, ferrying people, all sorts of things that they have done throughout the country during the worst of the second wave is proof of that. So the Youth Congress has done that. My own body, the All India Professionals Congress, has done smaller scale. We have at the same time set up doctors' helplines, lawyers' helplines. So we've tried to do all sorts of things within our capacity to try and make this work. I'm convinced in any case that once COVID is fully behind us, you will see the full face of a strong and determined opposition.
My final question to you, as a chairman of this IT panel, so how do you, the talks with the big tech companies are going? Do you think they are on their way to, agree for the Indian IT laws? And secondly, internationally, there is a rising, calls for raise taxes on these companies for the welfare of the people. So what's your stand on that?
No, so as far as the IT business is concerned, as chairman of the committee, there's some issues I can't discuss that are still before the committee. All I can say is the companies have come, they've testified, they've been asked questions repeatedly, not once, but many times. And the questions that we have asked have left them in no doubt as to the concerns and interests of the members. I will stress, however, that some issues are still to be determined. For example, I think on one or two questions, some of the companies have gone to the court, so the court will have to rule. And in some one or two cases where they had delayed compliance, they have now complied. Twitter has given all the names they had to give, etc. So my own view is that we will see some progress. There is no debate on the principle that any company working in India must follow Indian laws. That is obvious. But if the Indian law has got some elements that are not reasonable or whatever, then the courts and the judiciary are also available to help interpret this in a way that the companies will then have to abide to.
So on taxing the big tech companies for the land, so for example, they earn revenue from India, they spend that in India.
This issue has not been fully resolved. There's a whole global debate on this. Many, many companies, Europe, for example, has taken a stand. Australia has taken a stand. We'll have to see. I think India will certainly be grappling with this issue, as other governments have.
Thank you, Doc. So just now we spoke with Dr. Shashi Tharoor, and he says that the criticism of the Congress party working only in the social media is not true, but due to this rise of the pandemic, many members of the party are working through the social media, reaching out to the public. On the other hand, the Youth Congress is helping more people to get the essential supplies. He also answered our question related to the IT companies complying to the Indian laws and this big ongoing debate on taxing big tech companies, to pay in the soil they're earning profits. So with camera person Srikanth, this is Vaitheeswaran for ETV Bharat from Chennai.